Thank you. Honorable G.G. Ponnambalam, you have 6 minutes.
I have 7, sir.
No, the allocated time has been reduced because of the delay earlier.
Okay. Honorable Deputy Chairman of Committees, I'm glad I get to speak once again whilst you're in the chair. I wish to just make a comment with regards to the Honorable Field Marshal Sarath Fonseca. He mentioned my name whilst he intervened in this debate, and he gave me some advice to be cautious with what I say so that ethnic harmony can be maintained. I wish to point out to the Honorable Field Marshal that I'm very cautious about what I say. I'm very measured in what I say. I find it peculiar that he, of all people, can caution me, because in his previous incarnation as the army commander, he made it a point to point out that Sri Lanka is a Sinhala tree and that all others are creepers and crawlers on that Sinhala tree. Hardly words that come from a person who is not communal or racist, for that matter. Maybe he has changed since he lost that post and has been in prison or something like that, but I find it very odd that he would have those that advice to give me. Honorable Deputy Chairman of Committees, as you know, the Northeast is a part of this country that has faced a war, and it's been a part of the country that has been deliberately destroyed. For 32 years, we've had a war, and in the course of the 32 years, when Field Marshal Fonseca, at that time General Fonseca, when he was Jaffna Army Commander, places in the Northeast were under a complete economic embargo. A litre of petrol during that embargo cost 1,500 rupees. So that was the sort of conditions that the Northeast has to face. After 32 years of complete destruction, to expect that part of the country to be equated with the rest is just completely unfair. People are lagging behind economically for over 32 years. To expect them to compete on an equal footing with the rest of Sri Lanka is just not possible. And therefore, it is important. I made this point, I couldn't complete it during the debate on the government's policy statement. It is fundamental that the Northeast be seen separately, as apart from the rest of the country. There has to be special treatment given to that area. People's economy has to be built up. Without protecting what they have and enhancing that economy, to expect them to compete on an equal footing will actually throw them into a cycle of debt to a point where they cannot recover, and eventually they'll be forced to leave the country. But this government, as well as the previous governments, including the government that existed just before when His Excellency Maithripala Sirisena,
Honorable Member, you have 2 minutes left.
Didn't do that. One of the communities that have been so badly affected by this economic situation are the families of the disappeared, because those family members, as you will know, have lost their breadwinners. Most of the people who have disappeared are breadwinners, and they are in a pathetic situation. So pathetic that for the last 4 years or more, they have literally been on the roads protesting. And on the 30th, they are the International Day for the Disappeared will be adhered. It is our view that their struggle must be completely supported. We will do that. And we hope that the government acts on these issues. But unfortunately, the fact is that they are not going to. And the only way that families of the disappeared can seek justice is through an international investigation. Those are issues that we will continue to be strong on, because that is the mandate, Mr. Deputy Chairman of Committees, that the people have given us. There is also one other matter that I wish to raise, the question of political prisoners. Once again, those families whose Tamil political prisoners are under incarceration, they are breadwinners. And those families for years have not been given justice. When convicts can be pardoned, to have these political prisoners who actually don't have any evidence against them not be released, I think is a
Honourable Member, your time is running up.
It is a crime, and it must be addressed. I thank you.